I got the gig to work on the intro visuals for the first movie, but I hated the raised webbing thing. So even in that, I never really did a shot of Spider-Man that matched what the costume was they designed, even though I can't debate. That's a beautiful design. I just thought, like, where did he get the money to make that thing? You know, so the internal logic of it had my brain scrambled. And plus, it didn't have enough Romita in it for me to feel like the design I'd been desperate to see. And so when they hit me up about doing the intro visuals, I was kind of a difficult boy to deal with because I didn't want to do the main character the way he was. But I got to do good portraits of some of the actors who I liked, you know, certainly doing Willem Dafoe's face. Everything I do in publishing is planned for months in advance, and it's got to work with the schedule I have. But since Hollywood is considered to be prime, like, got to take your time the second, you know, you're asked to do something, you better do it right then. I turned down doing images that would have likely have been these images of the characters, the actors' faces that showed up in the initial credits that look like they're kind of being illustrations, but they're actually photos that they kind of scribbled all over to imitate what my style was supposed to look like. So the whole opening credits to me is this weird kind of concoction of, like, that, you know, there's my art, kind of, and then there's the parts that aren't my art that are meant to look like their art. I can't school you into what you like, because you're not wrong for liking what you like.